Thank you. Thank you. 9th of July. I do not know the time, but dusk has fallen, and still, of course, no word. When I asked the sergeant, he shrugged, as if I was asking about when it might next rain. These fools around me, laughing, drinking, arguing. Do they know what I've done? Do they suspect it? I feel they must all be guilty of something. And yet, they laugh, drink, argue. God knows what I've done. I wonder if his judgment could be worse than my own.
11th of July, 1916. Dusk. I sit now at the bedside of my dear friend, Henri Clément. The doctor has left, but I remain. I feel I must record the extraordinary twists of fate and fortune that have led me to be here. Breathing. Alive. Strong and well. While Henri lies unconscious, fighting for his life. It starts days ago, on a night patrol. I fell into some kind of pit. I was injured, unable to move, unable to escape. By all rights, it should have been my tomb. I cried for help, screamed myself hoarse. The effort left me parched, exhausted, and still alone. As the next night fell, as I cried what might have been my last cry for help, I could see the stars high, high above, beautiful, indifferent. And then Clément's face appeared at the top of the pit. He lowered himself to me, found a trickle of spring water there, and had me drink from it. It was cool and crisp, with a strange, sweet taste. Never has water felt more nourishing than that, administered by a dear friend's hand. I was saved. But of course, that is not the last twist fate's blade would stab into my back.